Republican family who had been Republican their whole life, generation after generation. And there was one soundbite that sticks out, and it was that, you know, the factory closed 10 years ago, I'm paraphrasing, but when our Democratic representation in the state came to talk to us, they were talking about things like pronouns. And that, and also the fact that there are a lot of voters, millions, in fact, of voters who, if they had Bernie Sanders number one, they had Trump number two, and vice versa. Is that kind of the spot, the starting point for maybe that glimmer of hope to sort of chip away at the establishment Republican credo?
Definitely. I think you hit on a crucially important point. In the background of all of this and accelerating these disastrous tendencies is a war that's been conducted against the population for 40 plus years, not just in the United States, over most of the Western world and other places too, like India. The war is called neoliberalism. It began with the late Carter years, took off with Reagan and Thatcher, expanded into Europe, continental Europe with their austerity programs. This was a program which was announced very clearly and was quite clear where it was going to go. So go back to Reagan's inaugural address. You may recall, he said, government is the problem, not the solution. Well, if government is not the solution, who is the solution? Decisions don't stop being made. They just shift from government, which is partially accountable to the general public. They shift from government to the hands of private concentrations of power, who are completely unaccountable to the public and who have a program laid out for them, in fact, by the economic guru of the neoliberal assault. Milton Friedman came out with a famous article saying the only responsibility of a corporation is to maximize profit for its shareholders and its management, period. Incorporation is in fact a gift given by the public with many advantages, but according to this thesis, it incurs no responsibilities. So here we have a decision to transfer decisions away from government, which has the flaw of being partially influenced by the public. So shift from there to the hands of unaccountable private concentrations of power, which have no commitment to anything except self-enrichment. Does it take a genius to figure out what's going to happen? This was combined, and the people who were doing the thinking, probably not Reagan, but whoever was writing his speeches and telling him what to say, understood very well that when you carry out a major assault against the population, you're going to have to eliminate the means of self-defense. There's one major means of self-defense: unions. Labor unions give working people, most of the population, chance to organize to defend themselves against the attacks by management and the state. So the first thing to do is destroy the labor movement. And in fact, Reagan's first moves were to attack the labor movement, even bringing in scabs, considered illegal everywhere except maybe South Africa. Thatcher in England did exactly the same thing, same policies. First move, attack the unions. And if you look over the record, the rate of unionization is very closely correlated